चैतन्य मिस्टर चैतन्य
सर।
आर वी रेडी
यस सर, वी आर रेडी सर।
रेडी ओके। गर्ग साहब, डॉक्टर गर्ग साहब।
यस सर।
या यू आर देयर, वेरी गुड। या लेट अस स्टार्ट नाउ। या माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। And today we are very fortunate to have another very distinguished resource person talk about integrated circuits layout designs. It is also one of the intellectual property right recognized by Government of India. Dr. Garg is with us today to share his perspectives and to share his experiences and to educate us on the subject. Dr. Garg obtained his master's and PhD from Indian Institute of Technology Kanpur. For the last 22 years he has been working with the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology as a senior director. See, you all know that, you know, the integrated circuits and semiconductors and integrated circuit layout designs is under the technology ministry, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, which is the parent body for all these electronics development in the country. And Dr. Garg is a thought leader, a trusted business growth strategist, having expertise in driving and articulating a vision, delivering strategic innovation, commercial stewardship, to building a robust administrative and operational system, setting the organization's rhythm, strategic planning, business process improvements, and ensuring compliance to local and global regulations and policies. Dr. Garg is also known to me for the last 10 or more years. When I was at National Research Development Corporation, we used to interact with very closely, and he has got a great passion to promote innovation, startups in our country, is promoting and is prepared a lot of policies, you know, policy interventions to promote innovation, entrepreneurship, startups in the country, particularly in the ICT technologies, information communication, electronic technologies. Serving in the capacity of a senior director in the Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, backed by his rich and prolific career journey of about 25 years in the various administrative accountabilities, he imbibed strong ethos of IITs as a research scholar, carved out a mission to contribute for the optimal growth of the economy by blending with technology and yielding innovation ecosystem. So I am personally aware of the contributions made by Dr. Garg in the area of information technology, electronics. And when I requested him to address our students, he was very kind enough to accept our invitation with very short notice, hardly not even 24 hours. No, I am very, very grateful to Dr. Garg sir for your accepting our invitation and your love and affection towards me, particularly because of my association with you. And I am very sure our students will be getting benefit out of your experience, out of your vision. And I request you to share and make our students worthy of, you know, we are all in the intellectual property era, the knowledge economy. Intellectual property rights plays very, very important role. And Dr. Garg is one such a personality who is promoting intellectual property rights in our country. Particularly, he is an expert as far as electronics and information technology is concerned. He plays a very important role, and he represents the government in many committees, national committees, international committees, bilateral collaborations. And our students are very, very fortunate today. I urge all the students to listen his class carefully and to note down all your doubts. At the end of the session, you please, as usual, you have been always very creative in asking and clarifying doubts. You also please come out with all your doubts and suggestions in the chat box to the extent possible, because Dr. Garg has to go for another meeting with the minister. So you will try to clarify as much as possible. In case time doesn't permit, then we will request Dr. Garg probably another occasion. And I request Dr. Garg to start his session. Dr. Garg, sir, floor is yours.
Thank you, Professor Purushottam. So kind to be of, so honored to with your kind words. The association of ours for the last 10 or more years has been a very, very enriching experience for me. And I thank you for giving me this opportunity to talk to this startup community, to this student community from Andhra. Andhra happens to be one of the important manufacturing hubs for electronics. And the students from Andhra have contributed deeply to the ICT sector. So whenever you go to the Silicon Valley or to Seattle in US, it looks like a mini Andhra. And that's where I feel very proud that this state has contributed immensely to the technology sector per se. And that is all because of very strong and robust educational system that Andhra has. Having said this, one of the important messages that was flashed in the chat box was when we are talking about the Semiconductor Layout Design Act, which was enacted in way back in 2008, and in 14 years we had just two protections. And let's first dwell upon the fact that why only two, in spite of this act being one of the enabling provisions under the TRIPS, where seven IP protections are mandated under the TRIPS agreement, which you might have been party to in your earlier lectures. And why, in spite of this being a full-fledged Government of India National Act and part of the global ecosystem, why only two protections? So let me first talk about the philosophic background of this, because first and foremost, whenever I am talking about IPRs, it is very important to understand that how IPRs are important in the technology perspective. So my perspective to IPRs is not just about protections, not about just recognitions, which research papers and review journals and others can give you, but it is about how do you give tangibility to the intellectual capital that is developed within a nation, within an industry, or by an individual. And that's what is the importance of IPR, that it gives some sort of a tangibility to the intangible intellectual capital that resides within a system. And why do you need that tangibility? This tangibility is required to actually transact it on a commercial level. You need to create economic benefits in a industry intensive economy where technology is the driver for economy. Understand, when we talk about economy, I'll take an example of three important geographical locations in the world. The first and the foremost being US, more than a $17 to $18 trillion economy, the world economic leaders for the last 60 years. Then on the other side, you have China, which is $12 to $13 trillion economy, fast emerging to be a very profound competitor to US. And regions I will come later. And third, when we talk about India, a $3 trillion economy with 1.3 billion people, a services hub of IT, as we call ourselves, we are the IT superpowers with more than 200 billion market, IT being a technology driven sector. But why US, in spite of they not having anything on IT services, the manufacturing having first shifted prior to the pandemic or prior to the global disruptions mainly shifted to China, and the services mainly shifted to India. But China, US still remains the economic leader. The sole reason is that the IP creation and its translation to economics is most profound in US as compared to any other geography in the world. And no nation has translated their technology might as beautifully as US has done. And now China, taking example from US, has started doing that. And you see that happening in the 5G space, in creating new mobile phones. Some of the mobile companies actually competing with the technology leaders from US. So OnePlus, the Vivo, the Oppos, competing with Apple and the Samsungs. And there where the innovation and IP has become important in China itself. India is a late starter to translating economics out of IP, in spite of we having a very deep and profound educational system, which I talked about earlier, in spite of we having a very, very sound technology manpower. But that has not resulted in any, because of two reasons. First, the industry research is a missing link in this country. Second, the academia industry partnership is again a reason for concern. And the third and the foremost is that our basic ethos or our basic philosophy is that the technology is to be shared, is to be leveraged by all rather than being concentrated in and be made monopolistic with the IPR systems do. So these are some of the basic reasons where IPR becomes. But because of these reasons, India did not translate its intellectual capital in form of manpower into economic might. And we lagged around. The manufacturing completely was wiped out from India. And now with the programs like Make in India and the Atmanirbhar Bharat, we are trying to once again put our foothold into the economic, into the manufacturing ecosystem. And here the IP becomes important. We had just two mobile companies in 2014. Right now there are more than 200 mobile manufacturing related companies. The Sri City in Andhra and Vizag have become important centers for mobile manufacturing, and even Amravati and other places. And these have become important manufacturing hub. But it started off with a simple and right now we are the second largest mobile manufacturer. But in spite of the fact that we are a manufacturing hub, and that doesn't create real value. If you take an Apple phone, a normal Apple phone cost you around $700 or so. And if you break down the cost of end cost, then the IP cost that is there in a mobile phone is around $200 out of the total $700. And the manufacturing cost is just $60 to $70. So in spite of US translating all its manufacturing to other geographies, the main core economic benefits come to US because the technology belongs to Apple as a company, which is based out of US. Now, if India has to succeed in its manufacturing, in its electronic manufacturing, and if we have to realize a dream of a $400 billion electronic manufacturing hub, then we have to do few things which are very, very important. First and foremost, expand the manufacturing capabilities. Expand the manufacturing capital that we are just not the assemblers, but creators of core IP, manufacturers of core IP, and they translating. We need to have a made in India phone with made in India IP. And that is important if we have to be the mobile giants of the world, not just the second largest manufacturer globally. At the same time, we need to understand that the IP created is in many forms. It's not just patents, it's not just copyrights, it's also many other forms in which the electronic manufacturing. If you break down the electronic gadget, to break down a mobile phone, it comprises of three basic IP components. Those IP components include technology, some software, and some electronic components laid out in a very innovative way. And that is where it becomes important that we need to understand that what are the forms of protection these three components have. The core technology, or way you put a technology in place, or the functionality that is built around a semiconductor, is protected under the patent law. The software or the embedded software that goes inside it is either a trade secret or is a copyrighted material as per the IP laws of the India. But the way the components on a semiconductor chip or a PCB are laid down and the way they are optimized is protected under the Semiconductor Layout Design Act. And that is what is important. The design of a chip translated into a unique optimized layout is what is protected by a Semiconductor Layout Design Act. And that is protected when you are doing that design for your own self. Right now, we are an outsourcing hub for such design. We have the capability. We have immense capability in that. We have more than 100 design companies in India, but none of them do it for themselves. They do it as an outsourcing hub for the large multinational giants outside India. Once these designs are done for your own self, once these designs translate into a new semiconductor chip, once these designs translate into an equipment or a gadget or an electronic gadget that belongs to India with all its components and functionalities developed in India, then this act will become important, and the number of semiconductor layout design protections will increase from 2 to 200 to 2000 to 2 million. So that was the introduction that I wanted to tell you about, that why in India this is a missing link, because still semiconductor is a subject of education. Semiconductor design is a subject of outsourcing in the industry, but it's not a subject of manufacturing or creating your own inbound unique electronic product. Can you, as students, can you name a product that completely belongs to India, designed in India, manufactured in India, and sold in India? Do you have any idea of any one gadget that is there, which has all the components that are in India and is very popular in the market? Any idea from any student? I think that's you also, and the 100 odd students which are actually participating in this talk, you also have no answer to that. So till the time we don't have this, the act has got limited application on ground, and that is important to understand. Now, coming to the IPRs or the semiconductor layout design, as I said earlier, it is part of the 7 IP protections that are mandated under the TRIPS agreement, a harmonized way in which IPRs have to be dealt under internationally under the WTO. One of them is the Semiconductor Layout Design Act, and to be compliant with this, the government of India came up with a Semiconductor Layout Design Act and was notified in the year 2008. Notified in the Semiconductor Integrated Circuit Layout Design Act. Oh, sorry, not in 2008, but in 2000. Protects original, inherently distinctive layout designs that have not have been previously commercially exploited. So the important thing to understand is that the IP in this layout should be original, should be yours, inherently distinctive from the others. And that is also a challenge, that how do you actually identify that it is inherently distinctive layout design which has not been commercially exploited earlier, and that is important. Registration is a necessary prerequisite for protection under this act. The Semiconductor Layout Design Act 2000 gives recognition to a new form of intellectual property, namely the layout designs used in semiconductor integrated circuits. This act in India was originally enacted by the Ministry of Electronics and IT, which I belong to. But after the 2016 IPR policy, which came, where consolidation of all IPR related activities were given to one ministry, that is the Ministry of Industries. So this act is now under the control of the Intellectual Property Office, under the Ministry Department of Industry Promotion. What is a semiconductor? A semiconductor is a material which has electrical conductivity to a degree between that of a metal such as a copper or that of an insulator such as a glass. That is basics, no? A semiconductor is neither a metal nor an insulator. It is in between, and when you give certain amount of power, the electrons jump from the base layer to the conducting layer, and that is when conductivity happens. In an insulator, that is not possible. You are not able to give that amount of power. In a metal, there are already inherent electrons in the conduction layer, and that is what. Semiconductors, as you also understand, are foundation of modern solid state electronics, including transistors, solar cells, light emitting diodes, quantum dots, digital and analog integrated circuits. So when you are talking about semiconductors, when you are talking about the layout of such semiconductors, you are not only talking about integrated circuits, you are also talking about transistors, solar cells, LEDs, quantum dots, and the integrated circuits as a whole. A semiconductor may have a number of unique properties, one of which is the ability to change conductivity by the addition of impurities called doping, or by interaction with another phenomena such as electric field or light. This ability makes a semiconductor very useful for constructing a device that can amplify, switch, or convert an energy input. Now, the important thing to understand is that when you are talking about these functionalities in a semiconductor, you are not talking about a Semiconductor Layout Design Act. What you are talking about is a patent act which enables us to convert this into this. But when a device is, when a number of such devices are built out of a semiconductor, now how do you put them together? You need a number of transistors, you need a number of diodes, you need a number of amplifiers, you need number of such things to create a single integrated circuit. An integrated circuit might have millions of such devices on a single microchip, and that's where the design capabilities lie. And they are, when these design capabilities are unique and they are protected under this in India under the Semiconductor Integrated Circuit Layout Design Act 2000, The semiconductor layout design gives recognition to a new form of intellectual property, that is the layout designs used in semiconductor integrated circuit, as has been defined under the Article 2H of the Act. Exchange of information on the world now, and understand this act is there in many countries, and this act has also got geographical boundaries. So if you have protected your semiconductor layout in India, you also need to protect it in other geographies, and the act might have some minor differences, and you have to understand that. So if you are protecting in India and you have markets in many countries, you must have protecting them for in those countries as also. The need for this sui generis form of protection developed primarily as a result of chip piracy, which threatened to undercut the vitality of the semiconductor industry, because a design is, other designs are inherently protected under the copyright law. So why do you need some other law when the copyright law was already there? The copyright law has an inherent limitation that it does not distinguish between the uniqueness of a final IP. It is protected as such, and it is understood that there is no plagiarism or piracy involved in it, unless and until someone challenges your copyright protection, saying that it has been pirated or plagiarized from their creation, then only there is certain. So it is a reactive law, not a active law. And that's where Semiconductor Layout Design Act becomes different, because in this, the amount of intellectual property that goes into the layout design, a new chip design may cost you anything from a few thousand million dollars to few billion dollars, and the amount of research investment that goes leads a more sui generis act, and that's why there is a prior search that is in, this is unique and there has been no piracy or plagiarism done in this layout design at the time of protection. So it gives more protection, it gives recognition to originality, whereas copyright law has a limitation that originality is only established if it is challenged. Chip pirates could sell identical chips for lower prices than could be the companies that only originally designed them. It is very similar to a medicine. Say, for example, when an antibiotics or a new molecule comes to the market, it says around 100 times costlier as compared to when it comes out of the IP protection. And that is basically because the company which has actually formulated that molecule or invented that molecular formula has invested a huge amount of money, and the legal systems in the world thought that it is appropriate to give them some monopolistic rights for a limited period of time to realize the research and development costs that went into that molecule. And similar is the case with the new IP chip design, because a substantive amount of investment goes there. So this actually protects legitimate companies that are engaged in chip research and decide to cut prices to compare with, and not to cut prices to so that they can compete with pirated chips, which deprives the legitimate companies of the funds needed to carry out further research and development to meet the next generation of chips. Because as per the Moore's law, you need to be upbeat every 18 months. The functionalities double in a chip, and the speed also doubles, and that's what the Moore's law, and you have to be competitive. It came way back in 1967 and still relevant for the semiconductor industry till date. Protection to semiconductor chips was first given in the US through the Semiconductor Chip Protection Act, SPA, way back in 1984, and its impact was felt virtually throughout the world. Japan introduced a similar protection in 1985, that is the Japan Circuit Layout Design Act, and European Commission directive with implementing legislation in the the next year. EU accelerated the international, resulting in the formulation of the 1989 Treaty on Intellectual Property in respect of integrated circuits under the auspices of WIPO. The IPIC treaty was later made part of the TRIPS agreement, and that's what I talked about earlier. TRIPS called for adherence to most of the substantive provisions of the IPIC treaty, which was actually spearheaded by EU. As a member of the TRIPS agreement, India enacted the Semiconductor Integrated Layout Design Act in 2000, but it is still to be enforced in a very, very proactive manner because of the lack of enthusiasm shown by the industry or by the designers of new innovative integrated circuit designs. The implementation of the act comes under the Ministry of Industry Promotion. A layout design has to be registered to receive the protection under the act. The act affords protection to the layout design of a semiconductor integrated circuit. Protection is given to a layout itself so that design houses producing design layout designs would have protection for these products separate from their incorporation in a chip product. Why it is done so? Why is it important? Let's understand. In a integrated circuits, if you have done a course, it is divided into four distinct categories. A category one is one which makes a semiconductor ingot called the silicon carbide or gallium arsenide or whatever. That actually, when it is doped with impurities, gives a PN junction or an NP junction. On this basic chip is a design done by a separate company called a design company. Once this design company comes with a new innovative design, it is given to a silicon chip fabricator, which is a very different company. It might be in India, it might be outside India. So in India, there is still no single semiconductor semiconductor fabrication company which is used. We have two sporadic examples of a government owned, that is Bharat Electronics Limited and SCL in Semiconductor Complex Limited in Mohali, but they are mostly government and related to strategic sector, that is defense and space, where they are manufacturing chips. So we don't have a chip. So what we am saying is there are three set of companies, and the IP flows from a semiconductor ingot or a PN junction to a design, to a fabricator, and then to a packaging company at the end. So there is a whole lot of different entities that are involved, and they need different type of protections to share the revenues that flow out of this. So it the protection under the act exists only after the has been registered. Layout design can be registered if they are one, original, inherently distinctive, capable of being distinguishable from any other registered layout design, and they have not been commercially exploited for more than 2 years before the date of application for registration. These are the four conditions on which the protection is based. Thus, the act does not require novelty but distinctness from the purpose of registration. So you do not have to come with a different functionality. You have to be distinctive in the nature of they being placed on a PCB or a chip. And that is important. A layer normally consists of a combination of elements and interconnections that are commonly known among creators of layout design and manufacturers of semiconductors, and hence are considered original only if such combination take as a whole is the result of the creator's own intellectual effort. So originality is important, not the novelty. Thus, this can be shown by the original combination of elements of design that are not by themselves original. Thus, a new topography may be a result of a combination of originally existing IPs placed very differently as compared to a prior design that exists in the market or in the research papers. One also important things also I want to say is that this act is distinctive from a patent act, but similar to a copyright act in the form that this IP cannot be duplicated in terms of commercial exploitation by any other unless and until the creator gives a license to it. But fair use is allowed under this act. So if you are making limited designs or copying limited designs for the purpose of research and development, that is allowed under this act. And that is important to understand that the fair use is allowed. The registered proprietor, what rights he has? He has the exclusive right to reproduce by any means the registered layout design or any substantial portion of this. He has the right to license it on an exclusive or a non-exclusive basis. But if anyone does it for scientific evaluation, analysis, research and development, that is allowed under the fair dealing exceptions, which is similar to a copyright law. The act also allows persons to reverse engineer layout designs for the purpose of analyzing the layout design and incorporating the insights of their analysis into an original layout design of their own, which is very different from the patent act, let us understand. Reverse engineering is not allowed under the patent act, but it is allowed under the Semiconductor Layout Design Act. Such a provision is considered to be justified in accordance with the Article 62B of the IPIC Treaty and the provisions of the TRIPS Agreement, as there is need to encourage creativity through the improvement of existing layout designs. Moreover, to successfully enter an integrated design circuit market segment with a new product, the new entry must usually be compatible with established products. What I mean to say is that any new novel design act has to be compliant with the existing standards and existing market practices, and that is very, very important to understand when you are going into innovation in this field, that you cannot survive the market unless and until you are part of the standards. So IP and standards are also very important components that a student of an engineering or a science student should understand, because until that is done. Now, the last point that I want to drive is that the act expressly lays down provision affording criminal remedies for the infringement of the layout design. If someone infringes, what are the rights of how can you actually enforce your right? So the act allows both civil as well as criminal remedies if someone infringes your layout design. But the act does not provide does not allow the criminal remedies to be upfront, but if the civil remedies fail, then only the criminal remedies are enforced. What do you mean by that? That if someone infringes, the first and the foremost is the court will establish methods by which economic losses of the creator are offset, but if that fails, they can also enforce criminal liability. Got it? Thus, it can safely be said that the civil remedies such as injunctions, the account of profits and damages would be applicable to enforce rights of the, and if they fail, then unlike the law of patents and design in India, as well as other international instruments for the protection of semiconductor topographies, the registered proprietor has criminal remedies for the imprisonment of layout design. And that is where it is a more profound act as compared to patent act, because most of the time, what the strategies that the companies take is that if you have a new or a novel design, it normally gives an enhanced functionality or an improved functionality or a novel functionality. So they tend to protect these functionalities as form of patents rather than enforcing the semiconductor layout design provisions. And that's why the number of protections are also low. And this is one of the reasons. And this is very important to understand. And now, how do you actually enforce your rights? If you have created a new novel design, then you need to go to the intellectual property office website and need to apply for registration of this. The registry will, or the registry will then establish the novelty or the uniqueness of this design and will give you a protection under the act. And that is why, that is how. So let me conclude on the various aspects that I have discussed in form of a Semiconductor Layout Design Act before I dwell into the next topic, that how do you actually promote a semiconductor industry and how do you integrate the various IP laws into that. There is a protection of semiconductor integrated circuits layout and designs by registration process. There is a mechanism for distinguishing which layout design can be protected. There are rules to prohibit registration of layout which are not original or which have commercially not been acquired. The protection is for 10-year period. It's provided to a new design. It is less than a patent, which is 20 years or 60 years under the copyright. And that is also distinguishes between the three acts. Provision regarding infringement and evidence of validity are mentioned. There are provisions for determining payments of royalty for registered layout designs in case of innocent or unintentional infringement. In cases of intentional infringement, there are civil and criminal validities that are available. The registrar is appointed for the purpose of, and there is an appellate board established for facilitating that reserve, and that gives you a fast track mechanism for infringement, for legal remedies for your infringement. Now, having said this, the last part of my talk will be that how do you integrate the three important acts that are there when you talk about intellectual property related to semiconductors. As I said, the three important acts that are related to semiconductors is one, the Patent Act, which protects the functionalities or new novel and having industrial application functionalities on the chip. The Semiconductor Layout Design Act protects the way these functionalities are placed on a chip, and the copyright law protects the embedded software that goes inside the chip. So these are the three basic components of IP that actually form part of a gamut of creativity which goes inside a chip, and that is important to understand. So the most commercial value that comes is creating new functionalities on a chip. If you only had a voice over IP functionality on a chip, then the next obvious innovation is that how do you incorporate a video over IP so that you can do video calls rather than only the voice calls. And that is important to understand. So the moment a next generation phone came with a voice instead of a voice with a video call, where you sitting in, say, for example, Vishakhapatnam or at any other place, is able to talk to a person in USA on a video call, that gives you a better experience of live, and that is an important functionality that comes on the chip. So that functionality, when incorporated, will obviously need to be protected under the patent act, because that's a stronger act. That act establishes it not only establishes that you can change the layout, it establishes that no one will come with a video call functionality which is similar to one that is created by you for next 20 years, unless and until he takes your permission or a license from you on that IP, and that gives greater economic benefit. So the people concentrate around patents rather than on design. The Copyright Act is important because it is easily piratable, and whereas the semiconductor layout design is not easily piratable under and until you are a design company which comes with a considerable amount of investment and expertise. But a software can be pirated easily. Most of us have been using for years Microsoft Office as a pirated version rather than a licensed version. And that's an example. 45% of the world software is a pirated version of the licensed version. And so it's also easy. But that piracy relates to mass scale exploitation of a software. And so the Copyright Act is also important, that to reduce a mass scale piracy, you need to enforce a copyright. Semiconductor Layout Design Act piracy is limited to one or few companies, and it is easily identified, and you can take legal or preemptive measures for stopping it. So the limited point that I wanted to drive in this is that the semiconductor industry is an important industry. It is an industry of the future, because everything and anything will become digital from now. If you talk about the healthcare sector, the future of innovation in the healthcare sector will be digital. If you talk about the transportation sector, the future is digital. It's Olas and the Ubers, the EVs and the AVs that will drive the transportation sector. It will not be this old age mechanical vehicles that will be there. The future of agriculture will increasing agriculture productivity, where the core number of people goes will be digital. The productivity will be increased by the number of sensors that are there in your farms, and that will increase the productivity. So if you talk about any sector of economy, you are talking about digital. And when you talk of a digital, the underlying element inside a digital instrument is a semiconductor chip. And that is where it becomes important. You will not only need billions of chips, you will need trillions of chips in the coming years. And you need trillions of sensors, billions of sensors with innovative designs. And that is where the future will lie. So Industry 4.0, which we are talking about today, an interconnected world, a world based on analytics and sensors, the world based around artificial intelligence, will be based around creating new innovative chips, leading to innovative sensors, leading to innovative analytics, and increasing productivity and better quality of services in all sectors of economy. And here the semiconductors become the core enabling mechanism. The government of India has realized it under its Make in India policy. They came up with an array of benefits for enabling this mechanism, and that has been done. And that's why we are having more and more incentives for the semiconductor layout designs. Semiconductors industry as such, whether it's a performance link incentive scheme or any other scheme that we are talking about. Thank you. Now I am open it for questions. I've got 10 more minutes, and I'll request. Someone asked me, can you explain the vacuum tube computers? So let's understand the diodes and the triodes and came before, which were vacuum tube based, where there was elements and there was a vacuum and the electrons can flow with flow of energy. And that led to a semiconductor form, which was subsequently taken over, and the vacuum tubes have actually been wiped out from the market. Any other question, please?
So we continue your talk. At the end of your talk, we can take all these questions one by one.
Sir, actually, I have finished with my whatever I wanted to. Now I thought I will have a 5 to 7 minute interactive session because I have to now. I've got another commitment. I have to leave at 6:15, sir.
Okay, sir. Why we our registrations are so low in case of the semiconductors and integrated circuit?
Two very important points. Establishing a novelty around a design is a very Herculean task, and most of because our act has got an inherent establishing the novelty, so that actually delays the level of protection in this country, and that has been one reason. The second is that people actually when this act came, the design was important, but now design as inherently a new novel design leads to novel functionality or an improved functionality. So people tend to protect it under the Patent Act instead of a Design Act. And that's why the number of protection is low. I hope with increasing emphasis on Made in India, with increasing electronic manufacturing, these designs will be normally a protection and provided it takes 3 to 4 years for a 10-year protection for a under in the Indian semiconductor layout design offices. Someone talked about the industrial designs versus semiconductor. So semiconductor integrated designs about semiconductor integrated circuits. Industrial design is about the way various instruments or various appliances are placed, which increases the supply chain or productivity inside an industry. Any other question, please? Can I ask a few questions?
There was one more question, sir, on the chat box.
Which one?
There is one more question on the chat box.
How long does protection last in layout of in 10 years? I talked about it. The protection is for a period of 10 years from the day of registration. And you can only apply 2 years subsequently to where your layout has been commercially exploited. It cannot be later. It cannot be more than 2 years. So total is 12 years that means.
So this also can be filed under PCT route also, sir,
in other countries? Reviewed. It cannot be filed under the PCT. Is specifically for, it's a patent cooperation treaty, it's specifically for patent. Any country which has a semiconductor layout design act, you have to file it separately in those geographies or countries separately. It cannot be a single application for filing it internationally. It can be reviewed. The review can be the first level of challenge can be to at the time when it is notified for a, you can get it reviewed by the intellectual group. But after the registration has been done, you have to take legal measures under the appellate authority.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, is it mandatory to file SIA registration in all, or it exists like copyrights? It's mandatory to apply in all those countries wherever you have got economic interest. It is not like copyright where it is a de facto protection. Some good questions that are coming.
No, the students are really very smart guys. We also used to enjoy listening to their questions and clarifying their doubts. The only thing is there will be some starting trouble. Somebody has to ignite.
No, then I find a very, this is a difficult act to understand. And when you are talking about economics and technology, so it is difficult to absorb as a student, because IPR has got no meaning until and unless you are talking about economics of technology or research. And being the NRDC chief, Professor Purushottam, you are the best judge of it. The challenge it took for NRDC to translate public funded IP, who better can understand than Professor Purushottam? So understand what are the challenges which are required, because unless and until the other day I was talking to someone and asked that how much money has flowed into the drone research in this country, and you will be amazed to know that 18,000 crores have been spent by the government for drone related research, and of that only 900 crores have flown into all those companies which are relevant for in the drone market today as form of startups. ST Microelectronics, Intel are the two majors in terms of the maximum number of semiconductor layout design protections globally. Gentlemen, last question, please. Before I wrap up, I have to move.
What is this?
Avi Teja is an intermediary between the.
Yeah, he's my colleague here.
Okay.
So he acts like a flex between us.
Great.
He clarifies some of the things, make them more. I think if there are no questions, shall we leave Garg Saab because he has to go for another meeting? Students, please come forward quickly. Another 2 more minutes. If you have any doubts, please come forward. If there are no questions, we will continue our discussion and doubts session. So if you have any specific questions, please quickly ask in another 1.5 minutes.
The performance linked performance linked incentives given by the Government of India recently is there to promote the semiconductor or the electronic manufacturing. We are coming up with a new scheme which will be announced where we'll be establishing our own indigenous fab in India.
Sir, can you just, though it is out of the topic for the benefit of the students, in 1 minute, how the Minister of Electronics helping students to come out with their innovative ideas or to protect IP or to promote startups, if you could just share, I think,
I'll just simply ask you that please visit our website called the mightystartuphub.in, which is an integrated one-shop window where we have actually brought in all the startup related and all the innovation and IP related incentives, whether it is in form of a center of excellence, whether it is related to handling queries, whether it is related to giving incentives for protection, all of this actually comes out. So what I will request you all as students is that please visit this site, please post your queries on this, which will be very, very helpful for you in terms of connecting yourself with deep tech innovation ecosystem that is being promoted by the Ministry of Electronics and IT. These students are from the city of
Visakhapatnam, sir. Most of them are 90%.
we have an IoT center there. The AMTZ is our promoted entity, if you know, and we have the whole STPI incubation facility also there in Visakhapatnam.
Industry 4.0 Center of Excellence is also, I think, you have sanctioned
And we are
recently.
establishing an RINL in RINL, our Industry 4.0 Center of Excellence, which has been announced recently.
So, students, if there are no questions further for today, I would like to thank Dr. Garg Saab on behalf of the Andhra University management, on behalf of all of you. Really, sir, I myself personally got enriched with your
No,
talk. Many things I also learned along with the students. Students, I think you all appreciate the kind of confidence, the kind of flow, the words and the depth of knowledge of Dr. Garg holds in the area of integrated semiconductors and integrated circuit layout designs. And he has very clearly told us what qualifies for a semiconductor integrated circuit layout design, what is the criteria for it, what is the difference between a patent, copyright, and integrated circuit layout design. And in the current era of digital world of Industry 4.0, the semiconductors and integrated circuit layout design are going to play a very, very important role. So you are all the future generation on whose shoulders the country's growth progress depends. So it is very, very important for all of you to understand the importance of different types of intellectual property right, including today's topic. And I once again thank Dr. Garg Saab for in spite of his busy schedule, for sparing his valuable time to talk to all of you. If you have any specific questions which we are not able to answer, definitely post it in the chat box. We will see to that your doubts are clarified. And as suggested by him, you can also reach out to him through the mighty startuphub.in. That is also a wonderful initiative of the Government of India. There are thousands of crores are being spent to promote innovation, IP, entrepreneurship in the country, particularly in the electronics, because I think after oil, the next big imports India is importing is that electronics. No? So it is very, very important for all of you to come out with original ideas and understand the Indian situation, the global situation in the electronics and information technology, so that see, electronics and information technology is a pervasive in almost all areas of our day-to-day activity. Without understanding IT, without having skills in IT and electronics, I think our own survival itself will be in a question mark. You know, you cannot perform, you cannot grow. So that is why it's very, very important. Once again, I thank Dr. Garg Saab for sharing his perspectives on this subject matter with all of us. Thank you, sir. Thank you once again.
अच्छा सर, एक और है
हाँ
सर।
जी,
थैंक यू
हेलो,
सर, थैंक यू, सो काइंड ऑफ यू फॉर योर काइंड वर्ड्स। थैंक यू।
इट इज आवर प्लेजर सर. वी लुक फॉरवर्ड फॉर योर कंटिन्यूड सपोर्ट. वी आर गोइंग टू हैव ए सो मेनी प्रोग्राम्स इन द आईपी एरिया, एंड बीइंग यू आर वन ऑफ द नेशनल एक्सपर्ट इन दिस एरिया, वी सीक योर ब्लेसिंग्स एंड सपोर्ट इन ऑल आवर फ्यूचर प्रोग्राम्स एज वेल. थैंक यू. Yeah, if you have any questions, let us start deliberate upon that. And I think how many we have? Another two more talks. One is on the patent, how to analyze patent documents, and what is the structure of patent documents. It's very, very important. We are going to have one lecture from Biotechnology Industry Consortium Limited, a Government of India organization. One Dr. Dara Ajay is going to speak on that. And another lecture, tomorrow we are going to have another beautiful lecture from Professor Padmavati from IIT Kharagpur. She is a professor at the Rajiv Gandhi School of Intellectual Property Law. She is also very, very accomplished professor in the area of intellectual property right. She is going to talk again on another aspect of intellectual property right. So please attend in large number of audience or participants, you know. That is the respect what we can show it to them, you know, when we invite somebody such a great personalities, we should pay our respect only by attending in large numbers and asking good number of quality questions the way you have been asking. So let us have an exciting lectures tomorrow and on Monday. With that, I think we'll be completing our syllabus as per the prescribed syllabus what has been given to us or what has been given to you. So we can spend probably another one or two classes on the clarifying the doubts and how to prepare for examination. You know, we will have one or two quiz competitions or some assignments or quizzes, we can do it so that you will be familiarized yourself on answering those questions. So we need to decide how to conduct this examination, whether it is a online mode or offline mode, that we will discuss with the examination branch and we will come back to you in a day or two, you know. So let us see how it's going to shape up, but we'll have a clarity probably by Monday or Tuesday once this classes are over. Okay, thank you very much, and if you have got any specific questions, please keep raising and we'll try to answer, not only in today's topic, any other general topic which related to intellectual property rights. Okay, Ravi, you can take over and continue the deliberations. Mr. Surendra, Surendra from computer center.
Sir.
Yeah, the Ravi.
Sir.
Ravi Teja, I think he's not able to speak. Kudana, kudiga unmute cheyandi.
Ravi Teja, CH, sir.
Ravi Teja, CH.
Yes, sir. We have done, sir. We have done, sir.
Okay. Ravi, you please continue the discussions and talk to them and see if they have any specific requirements. Take their requirements and see how best we can help them.
Yes, sir. Students, if you have any questions, please write to IPR chair at the rate on state.edu.in. If you have any questions regarding the exams or regarding any doubts in the classes, you can also write to that. I'm again posting it to you here in the chat box. Please use that email ID to clarify your doubts related to the subject. If anyone is having any difficulty in accessing the attendance links or the some people not able to register at the beginning of the course, you may also approach the IPR center. As sir said, the exam will be conducted within a couple of days. So please refer to the link given for the accessing reference materials. Please go through the IPR Academy book that is in the references folder. That book, all the IPRs that we have discussed in the classes every day, that has been mentioned clearly. Please go through the concepts of it. Make yourself aware with the basics of IPR. Thank you. If you have any questions, we are here to help you. Please, you can write to us or you can come down to the IPR cell. You can write to IPR chair at the rate amrauniversity.edu.in. We'll be happy to help you. And also there is a folder in the references section, IPR events and all. you may please check that folder. In that folder, you can see the FDP program, AICTE approved FDP program is being considered. It is being organized from 8th to 12th of November. You may please register to that also. Thank you. Gurla Devi Ranjita, you have asked about potato farmers versus PepsiCo company case. This is related to, I think, the PPV FRA. That class will be taken up tomorrow, and after the class, you may ask the speaker, or you can contact the IPR chair. We'll be happy to help you. That class is tomorrow. That is related to the PPV FRA. So you can hold on to your doubt for one more day. You can ask the speaker yourself. Okay. I hope it will help you. Yeah. Thank you. Please refer to the reference materials posted in the drive, the Google Drive. The link is shared with you all. And please make yourself aware with the basics of the subject. We'll also be posting some questions, model questions. You may also practice them. That will be available in the references folder. We have not posted yet. We'll be posting it in one or two days. So you can practice those questions also for the exam. If there are any more doubts, you may please put it in the chat box. Otherwise, we can end the session right now. Okay, then I think we can end the session. Surendra Garu, Computer Center.
Sir, sir.
Sir, I think the class is over. The students are also not having any more doubts right now. So I think we can end
the session. Can I stop the recording, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Please go ahead.